Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And we've all worked with some type of flat file, a delimited file, like a CSV file or a tab delimited file. And we're usually trying to use that file to load it into a warehouse or a lakehouse. And a lot of times people are just dropping those files into a folder. And I need to figure out which one is the latest file so that I can just load that file into my lakehouse or warehouse. It's not that easy sometimes, and we build manual process. Wait, enough of all this talking. You know what I like to do? Let's head over to my laptop. So we build these manual processes that look like this. In Fabric, when you create a lakehouse, you get both a table and a file section, which I like. And so in this case, I've created an archive folder and a stage folder in the file section. And then I've built out a process, and we've all done this type of pattern before, where I've built out this process that will stage the file. So maybe it's not me, maybe it's someone else that's creating a pipeline using some data extract tool to load that data into the initial stage area. Well, I've created a pipeline here to do that. And then you may use pipelines or some other tool, but I've created a notebook that will process that data from that staging area into the lakehouse table that I want. It could be a warehouse also. And so I just have it to append as new data comes in. And I've also created a schema so that I can explicitly specify the data types that I want. And then the entire process would look something like this. If you own the process to extract the data out of the source, here's the where I'm extracting the data out. Here's where I'm calling the notebook to process the data and get it into the lakehouse. And then this particular pipeline is going to take that file and move it from my staging area to that archive area that is in my lakehouse. So I'm using these two folders. So the data initially lands here, and then it's moved out to archive as I process that data. And we've all developed those patterns. You may be using a similar type of pattern, or maybe it's expanded out because you're iterating through files. Who knows? But the Fabric team has done something interesting, I would say, and it automatically will handle incrementally loading files from a particular folder into another destination. And that's what I want to show you in this video. Check it out. So I have this stage folder right here. Let me refresh to make sure we're seeing my latest data here. So you can see that I have about six CSV files that has data in it. And I want to move that data into a lakehouse table. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into my workspace, and let's go into the incremental folder. And I'm going to say, give me a new item and let's do copy job. So let's call this incrementally load CSV files. Click create. And so we'll be presented with a screen and saying, hey, choose your data source. And you can see there's different data sources that's available. I can go SQL Server, Azure SQL Database, Blobs, S3, or ADLS Gen 2. I'm going to use the lakehouse in Fabric because I have both of those sections. I'm going to pull the data from the file section, and I want to write it to a managed table in my lakehouse. And then what's going to happen is you'll be presented with two options, tables or files. And then what you'll see when I click files, it's going to load up the folders. And I just want I want the files in this folder. So I'm going to click, and then you can see you're presented. Do I want to make it schema agnostic? Here's my format. And then once it loads the preview, you'll be able to switch to different delimiters. I'm okay with this. Yes, first row is headers. And then here is my data. So then I'm going to click next. And then it's going to say where you want this to go. Well, in fact, I want this to go to the exact same place. And you can choose those other sources as your destination. I just happen to choose the lakehouse. But instead of going back to the file section, I'm actually going to create a table in my lakehouse. So use tables. We'll give it a name. We're going to call this internet sales copy job. We'll call it copy job. I edit my mappings. Remember, in my notebook, I created a schema so I could explicitly specify my data type. So I'm going to do that with my edit mappings. And it's all a graphical user interface, so I don't have to write any code. These four I know are integers, so it's a really good list of data types here. So I switch these over. You only have to do this once. You don't have to do this every time you load your data, and this is a date. So it's like one and done. I have another integer here. Where are you? There we go. And then these are floats because I don't know the precision. I'm not quite sure. So these are going to be floats. These will be strings, and then this one will be a float. And then I click next. Hey, do you want to do a full copy or incremental copy? This is where it gets exciting. I'm going to choose incremental copy. And what it's going to do is going to say, hey, there's all these flat files. I'm going to load those up into this table. And as I add new flat files, guess what it's going to do? You got to stay tuned. So I'm going to choose incremental copy, and then I'll click next. Look at this scroll bar, right? I don't want this to be scheduled. So I'm going to say, don't start this automatically. I don't want to do that because we want to take a look. So we'll click save, and then I can see it's all laid out. The source is the lake house, it's the file section of my lake house, and then this is the table section. I can run it. If I go to settings, I can set different things about it. I can even specify a schedule if I want. There's no schedule right now. I could schedule it directly from the interface. I could change my data sources. I could edit my mappings. If I go to advanced settings, I can say don't append, just overwrite the existing data. Be careful with that setting because it gets rid of all the data and just adds whatever the new data is. And that's not what we want. We just want it to continue to append. So I choose append. Click cancel. Let's go ahead and run this. So I'm going to click run. So it's reading each one of those files and it's loading each one of those files into the managed tables area of my lake house. So now my rows are loaded into my lake house. I'm going to go, I have a notebook here, and let's refresh that so we can see my new table created. Expand that out. There we go. So there's my internet sales copy job. Go here and I'm going to open my analyze sales. This is the notebook I want. And then here's my tables. And so I have a query here. So we're going to call this internet sales copy job I. And let's run this and let's see what data is in here. So we're going to go ahead and run this. May take a few seconds because it's got to start up my session, but sessions start pretty quickly. We have 17, 19, 20, 21, and 22, and 23. So now you can see that the files that were in that folder, they got all loaded into the table in my lake house. But since we've been doing this, a new file was added for November the 24th, and I only want to process that file. Now, I don't have to move these files to another location and worry that my copy job is going to pick it up because it just knows. And let's refresh, and you'll see a new file is added. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to my incremental job, and it should equal the number of rows in that file. That's what we should see. So I'm going to go ahead and run this. Okay, so just 142 rows, which is exciting. Let's go back to our notebook and run the query. Hang on, here's my notebook. Let's go back to our notebook. Let's run this query and 142 rows. So 142 new rows here, and that's what my job said. We had 142 rows. I can continue to add files. We're missing the 18th. I can go and drag the 18 in there, and guess what? It's just gonna pick up the 18. It's amazing. So it works with flat files, like I said, and it does a good job. It minimizes clicks and saves us some time. Also, it does work with SQL Server, relational sources, and if you wanna see a video on that, you gotta let me know where in the comments below. All right, what do you think? Have you used a copy job item or using patterns like this and maybe this could help? I'd love to know. Post it in the comments below. If you wanna learn more about Fabric on all the workloads in Fabric, including my favorite, oh, here it goes, Power BI, take a look. There's probably a video flying above my head. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.